Namaste. Welcome to my channel. This is Dr. Shreya Tayen, also known as Empress 1111. I want to talk to you on a much deeper level when it comes to the betrayal of Judas to our beloved brother Jesus. I'm going to be speaking to you in esoteric and metaphysical terms, and how this relates to your twin flame union. And even for those of you that are just on your soul journey and your spiritual path, period. Okay. Now, Judas and the crucifixion are synonymous for each other. Okay. There's a Judas Iscariot amongst us. Had Judas never betrayed Jesus, the crucifixion or crucifixion would have never taken place. Your divine counterpart had to betray you in order for you to become self-realized and self-actualized. Let's dig a little deeper into what I'm saying so we can see closer into this thing that I'm speaking of. Don't let your eyes and your ears deceive you in this, thinking that Judas Iscariot didn't play his part, because he played the most integral part that there was to play. You see, he was a traitor. And so have some of your divine masculines become. Now, before some of you divine masculines incriminate me, I'm going to make a distinction and say that the masculines did not play their part, and they are the ones that betrayed the divine feminines. And notice that I said masculines, lacking of all divinity and unworthy to be called divine. For those of you who have ears, let them hear. These are the words that Jesus said to his disciples, meaning that there were more esoteric layers to the message that was being said or conveyed. In modern code, what Jesus was really saying to them is, do not let your eyes and your ears deceive you, because I am giving you these messages in the form of divine codes. Now, depending on your readiness of awareness, and also dependent upon where the disciples were, whether they were single-minded or double-minded in their thinking, determined on whether or not they would receive the message from the divine. The divine counterpart is used as a catalyst to awaken us to our journey back to oneness and back to wholeness within ourselves. And until we learn to give up the ego, we will remain the same, meaning that union with self cannot take place. Responsibility for your own actions speaks louder than words. There is a cosmic smoke signal, a SOS, which means save on soul, that has been put out for those that are ready to move forward in the cosmos and do the right thing by taking the next step into their journey, even if it means to walk it alone. The highest vibration and frequency of the divine masculines and feminines are required at this moment in time, in all directions and time and space. The only person that can make this happen for you is you. So it is in your court. Now you know how and what to do. With determination and gratitude for your journey and help along the way, be ready to leave the past behind. The future is bright and is waiting for you. It is awaiting your arrival. Just know that you are in my thoughts and my prayers are with you. This is just a tiny ripple in a vast sea of your infinite blessings. I would like to go a little bit further with you on this. I want to get deeper than Lemuria with you. The core message of the Gospel of Thomas, it appears in saying in chapter 22, and there are some other logias that ring changes in the theme of the two becoming one. Looking back towards the androgynous unity that existed before the diversity found in worldly creation, this theme of unity finds a similar message in sayings that give the solitary or single one a special status. Some who agree that the two becoming one theme is at the heart of the gospel, regard it principally as part of an early baptism rite. Can be seen as a dramatization of the initiates putting off the body, putting on the light body, and returning to the sexual oneness, to the androgynous primal Adamic human being. It was, in this view, a mystery rite, ensuring the initiate of oneness with God. That is the grand beloved, our beloved, and with one's heavenly mate. Now, in many religious systems, the union of man and woman is considered an apt metaphor for the unitive experience, a succession of self-awareness and a moment of intense awareness. And in literature, art, and ritual, ultimate oneness has long and often been expressed in erotic imagery. We see this in tantric Buddhism. We see this in Kama Sutra, a mystical system in which the commodious word love has been explored to its utmost. Offers the yab-yum, joint figures of the male god embracing his female counterpart, holding her close before him, face to face, body to body. Does this sound familiar in the twin flame union? They form a union of compassion and thought. The two central ideals of the Buddhism, especially the late Buddhism teachings, are the two final states of human consciousness before it realizes nirvana. A Taoist symbol is a more familiar in the West, as the yin and the yang, the female and the male energies. They enfold each other to form a circle, a complete circle, itself a universal expression of perfect unity. I know you've seen it. Another symbol of unity is widespread. Man and woman as two beings is one person, neither male nor female, but both combined in one. Androgyn, tomato, tomato. The term for this symbol of union should not be confused with hermaphrodite, a person with physical attributes of both sexes, but in a literal sense. Okay? We are told that some early rabbinical writings present Adam in that guise. One version of the old Greek translation Septuagint of Genesis reads, male and female created he did. Instead of the familiar them in the first century AD, some Jewish writers combined these writings with two other scripture passages. One speaks of the Lord shaping me back in the front. The other from Genesis reads, the Lord God took one of his sides. These rabbis also knew Plato's myth of the severed spheroids, who were the first human beings. Now we can look into this, and we can also see in a Talmudic story, which was pretty much developed like the one that Plato speaks about. God made the first human two-sided and two-sexed, then split these creatures and made two bodies and turned them around to effect the creation with which we are familiar with today. This is the reason why you see in the Indian pantheon, most of the gods have four arms. This represents the unity, and it represents both male and female. And according to later medieval Jewish mystics, marriages are indeed made in heaven. Every soul, originally two sex at the beginning, is divided at birth and is incomplete until it finds its missing half. And so this puts you on the path to the reunion and the twin flame journey. Plotinus describes his attainment of oneness several times. When the soul has reached his height there, is no longer a duality, but two and one. For so long as the presence holds, all distinction fades. It is as lover and beloved here long to blend. A copy of that union, the soul has now no further awareness of being embodied. There is an overcoming of the division of Adamic man, woman, and Eden, which was the beginning of the differentiation, and a restoration of the oneness as a result of their reunion. Now, a French scholar finds collaboration of such a view in Epithesophia, which I've already mentioned, a book that he wrote yesterday, The Perfect Matrimony, it's Samuel Weir, okay? Where Mary Magdalene feels this interior man in herself and identifying with him understands, overstands, understands all, which is another great book to read, by the way. Jesus also said, come to know what is in front of you, and that which is hidden from you will become clear to you. For there is nothing hidden that will not become manifest. The same thing applies to you when it comes to your journey on this twin flame journey. Now let's go back to Judas. Do you remember or even know what position that Jesus gave to Judas? The position that Jesus allowed for Judas to have was Judas was his treasurer. You see, this Judas represents the unredeemed life forces, which are what? Think about it. The treasures of your heart. He also typifies that in humanity, which though it has caught a higher vision of life, still resorts to underhanded methods in order to meet its obligations. Judas carried the money bag or the treasure box, and he betrayed Jesus for 30 pieces of silver. How many of your masculines betrayed you for worldly pursuits? I want you to really think about what I'm saying to you right now so you can fully receive this transmission. The first step in our redeeming the Judas faculty is to assume a fearless attitude of mind, affirming our unity with the spirit of purity. When we do this, the Lord answers. Thou hast said, and the redeeming, uplifting, transmuting forces are set into motion and operation. When the Judas faculty reaches the spiritual standard of life, it is known as Judah, whose office is praise and thanksgiving. Praise and thanksgiving call into activity greater expressions of spiritual substance and any larger avenues through which we may receive spiritual life. You see, when we give praise and honor, we become glorified and our latent powers become actualized and we come into our own sovereignty. And as a free moral agent exercising this divine sovereignty, we become one with our true beloved, and that is our source creator, Mother, Father, God. Doesn't the story of Judas sound familiar to you? I really want you to think about it. Didn't your masculine or your feminine steal your heart? And it feels like as if he or she threw you away but kept the key. Divine masculines, doesn't it feel like your feminine stole your heart, betrayed you too? Divine feminines, it's not just only happening to you, my dear, but it is happening to the divine masculines as well. It feels like you both have been chewed up, spit out, and ran over. Both, metaphorically speaking, emotionally, and literally. You see, the metaphysical meaning of Judas, it represents the ego that has possession of the sex or life center in the organism and is using it for their own selfish ends. Judas was a thief. The selfish use of life and vitality of the organism for the gratification of the sense pleasure robs the higher nature and the higher self. And a spiritual man is not built up. He cannot fully manifest himself in this lower vibrational state. This is the very betrayal of the Christ. Is this not the very thing that your divine counterpart has done to you? No wonder Spirit gave me this message. It is so fitting. When you are fully forewarned, you are forearmed. And now you know how to operate. Now let's speak further in terms of metaphysics. The Bible speaks of Judas having a devil. Now, metaphysically, the devil and Satan are the same. The devil signifies the mass of thoughts that have been built up in the consciousness through many generations of earthly experiences and crystallized into what we deem or term as the human personality or the carnal mind. You see, it is the old template and programmings that are playing in the background. This is the other name for devil. It's sense consciousness, all the thoughts and one that fight against and are adverse to the truth that belongs to the state of mind that is also known to the metaphysicians as the devil. There are many of your counterparts that are fighting against the truth of this twin flame union. They cannot fathom something this strong, something this magnetic is even real. They even think that you're obsessed with them, not realizing that they are not even fully in acknowledgement of themselves. Do not your counterpart not have the personality of many lifetimes pent up in his or her person, that they have become familiar with themselves on this earthly plane, and they're just playing out their own reality as they know it to be. You see, the crucifixion is the death of the ego the giving up of the whole personality, surrendering yourself to source, being in full alignment of what it is that you need to do next on this beautiful journey. We are the ripples. We are the tiny ripples in the vast sea of infinite blessings. We are all journeying and soul journeying into this beautiful unfoldment and development, connecting with our higher selves, allowing for the crucification to take place through the crucifixion. We became awakened. Our pineal gland has become activated. We are tapping into hidden realms of reality. This journey is more than just a physical manifestation of companionship. This is a divine partnership. We are all part of a royal priesthood. We have all been anointed and appointed for this journey. And even if we have been betrayed by Judas Iscariot, the Christ within us is still going to be resurrected. This is your resurrection day. Hold your head erect. Lift your heads up to the heavens. And know that you have been fully equipped for this journey. All right, I have come to the conclusion of this audio broadcast. It is a good karma to like, share, comment, subscribe, leave a donation. I also have an Amazon registry. Whatever you purchase will be used on this channel. I now wrap you in my love, and I cloak you with the light of Christ consciousness. And so it is, Ashe.